Hi everyone, Fritz here. As you can see, we're back in the office. And I think it's about time that we went over the different kinds of life insurance. Now, when it comes to life insurance, we're really only looking at two different kinds. We have temporary coverage, also known as term insurance, or permanent insurance. Let's first take a look into term life insurance. Term life insurance covers you for a specific window of time, typically 10 to 30 years. And group term is typically what's offered by employers. So if someone has life insurance already through their work, it's typically a group term. The term in which that you have insurance is usually met under a timeline for individual plans, again, 10 to 30 years, or so long as you're employed. The moment you stop working, you stop having that life insurance. And term is a very affordable plan because it's held for only a specific amount of time. If we really, really look at it, 90% of the time, people have a term and they never use it. And that's why they're so cheap. That doesn't mean that they're bad. These are actually very, very good plans if you have low income or if you're very young and you're just starting out in your life. Because you may not have a family, you may not have a lot of debt, you may not have a lot of assets that have accumulated debt potentially, like a home or car. So you may only have a small protection plan just to give some money back to your loved ones and to cover your final expenses. Now, these same companies that offer term life insurance may offer you a window of time in which that you can convert that term policy to a permanent one, say a 5-year window. And permanent policies, we're typically looking at either whole life or universal life. Whole life has been around a whole lot longer than universal life, so let's talk about it first. Whole life policies are pretty simple in that they last you for the entire length of your life so long as you continue to pay the monthly premiums or annual premiums depending on how you have it set up. They give you guaranteed cash value, which you won't see in a term insurance policy. These cash values are guaranteed typically at a rate of 3 to 4%. When you get a whole life policy, your monthly rates as well as your determined face value is pretty much locked in for the rest of your life. So you don't have to worry about at the end of 10, 20, 30 years, your premium goes up. Your premium is fixed as well as your face amount is fixed. Getting into universal life. Some people like a lot of flexibility, they like to play around with their policies, that maybe they want to invest a little bit more. That's where universal life comes in. This is going to be for people that want more flexibility, where you can adjust the face value, you can adjust the monthly payments in order to meet your life's needs as you get older. Now, in exchange for that flexibility in universal life, you have something called a maturity date. The maturity date is when you reach a certain age, and this is typically an elderly age, say for example, 122. When you reach age 122, the company will just give you all of your cash value. You won't have any more protection, but you will just get your cash value once you reach that age. Now, some of you might be saying, well, I'm not gonna live to age 122, so perfectly fine. And that's the trade-off that you get with universal life. You have a whole lot more flexibility while you have the plan. You can have it do something called mirroring the market, like a variable universal life, or you could get an index universal life. This is where you operate within a specific percent return. For example, you may have a 1% floor and a 15% cap, meaning that no matter how bad the market does, you will always get a 1% return. Or no matter how well the market does, the most that you can ever get is 15%. And if the market does anything in between 1 to 15%, that will be your return. Now, you might be saying to yourself, which one is the best out of all three? Term, it can expire. Whole life, 3 to 4%, that only beats inflation. And then you look at universal life and you say, I don't know about that maturity date. I'm pretty healthy, I eat good, modern medicine's getting better, I might live past that maturity date. There are positive and drawbacks to each policy. If you're very, very young, maybe you wanna just get a term because that's what all that you can afford right now. Maybe you're still in school. But within that 5-year window, potentially, you could get a better job, you'll be starting to make a lot more money, you may start a family as well. So you may wanna upgrade to a whole life or a universal life. Some people even have both. And it's not that one is better than the other, but maybe they just wanna make sure that they have insurance when they pass away. That's where the whole life kicks in. They also want the tax benefits of investing in life insurance. And in order to get more than inflation, they take the universal life as well and then use that as an investment vessel. That's a strategy that you could definitely do. Some people even get a term life when they have a permanent one in order to protect the cash value. Say if you have a living benefits rider in your term insurance, you can use the money in the term insurance in order to save the cash value in your permanent insurance because you've lost your income because you're unable to work if you're sick. So there are different strategies, and it's not that one is better than the other. So it would be wrong of me to say that one type of life insurance is better than the other. One may be more suitable for your certain needs, but if you want to get into very, very technical strategizing for your long-term planning, then maybe you want to have a combination of two or all three. And for that, it's going to vary from person to person. I can't say which is the best way to go if you want to protect it with a term, if you want to have both a whole life and a universal life. That's not for me to say. It's really for you to decide once you're properly educated, once you have everything in front of you and you have a professional to guide you in your journey to financial independence. I hope that this video cleared up some of the differences and questions that you may have had on the different types of life insurance. If you have any questions for me, please leave it in the comment section below, and I'll see you in the next video.